Good morning, YouTube. Well, we're back at the potato eye experiment. Now, about a week ago, I put some eyes that I peeled off the potatoes with no actual potato attached. Get these out of here. These are just commercial potatoes from the grocery store, and you can see totally backlit here, that the large eyes from the russet potatoes have definitely set root. Drop the one I wanted to show you. Bang the tripod, girl. Okay, let's try with the flashlight. And the little tiny ones from the baking potatoes, these were the extra large baking potatoes. Didn't say on the package what type of potato they were, but where are we? They have started to grow roots as well. So we are going to not plant, but put these maybe we'll tuck the roots in a little bit or not. This is just moistened potting soil mixture. Not even a good potting soil mixture, but we aren't going to qualify as a properly scientific experiment because I want to keep the two types of potatoes separate here. So they will be in slightly different growing conditions. This tray is all russet. Trying to put the majority of roots down. best I can. Even the tiniest of single eyes have started roots. Some have actually managed to grow their roots right into the paper towel. Now, there are dozens of people claiming that cinnamon will kill off fungus gnats. I don't particularly believe that, but we will try it out here. Of course, if I see any real sign that one of these is working and the other isn't, then I'm going to apply that treatment to the other one. Now, I was reading a study published on a greenhouse supply company's webpage. And they said that BTK spray will kill fungus gnats in the larval stage. So I mixed up a fresh batch of BTK, which is a live bacteria that is completely harmless to humans and mammals. Humans and mammals? Humans are mammals. It is completely harmless to all mammals. And deadly to caterpillars. I keep this on hand to help fight cabbage worms. So we're going to spray this side down with the BTK. Now, when I was transplanting my peppers the other day, I noticed, at least on the serranos, the roots you could see there were in fact fungus gnat larvae munching away on them. So I haven't quite decided if I want to try this on them yet, because I'm not sure if it's going to, if it affects fungus gnat larvae, I'm not sure if it's going to affect ladybug larvae, which I need to keep healthy to fight my aphid issue. Like JT Bear, I am entrenched in the aphid war. Actually, I'm nowhere near as bad as he is now. All of my plants went outside and didn't start coming in until they were in danger of frost. So I didn't bring any aphids in with me, I don't think, because what are we now, 3-4 months later, there's no aphids to be seen anywhere yet. So, there we are. Cinnamon versus BTK experiment coupled with the potato eye experiment. Okay, we're back. Beginning of this video, I said that we were going to be doing cinnamon in this bed and BTK in this bed. I went and reread the article, and it's not BTK that you want to apply to kill fungus gnats, it's BTI. BTK is what you use to kill tent caterpillars and cabbage worms. BTI Come on, focus. Is Bacillus thuringiensis israelensis. Probably butchered that. BTK is Kurdistani. Now, this product is friggin' expensive. This bottle, 200 grams, it's a 500 gram bottle. So some sites, some websites list it as 500, some as 200. It's 200 grams of the bacteria on finely ground corn cob. You can see it down here, where I did an extremely pitiful job of sprinkling it evenly over top of that that planting. But it's naturally occurring bacteria in soil, and it works on mosquito larvae, black fly larvae, and a couple of other small flying insect larvae, including apparently the fungus gnats. Now, I could only find two listings for two products. One is this Aquabac. The other is Mosquito Dunk. Mosquito Dunks. This is considerably more product than you get with the Mosquito Dunks, but it's considerably more expensive. This bottle was like $30. Canadian. The Mosquito Dunks, the package of 9, I believe, is $22 Canadian, or the 2-pack is about $6. But I couldn't find anybody that actually had them in stock. It's too early for them to carry it up here yet, because we're still under 3 feet of snow. But if you can find the Mosquito Dunks 2-pack, that's the way I would go. And so you can spend the $6 on that and go to the dollar store and get looks like a Bondo file or a miniature cheese grater. Get one of those to grate it up into a coarse powder, Now, I've sprinkled this stuff on the top of the soil, and I put about a half a teaspoon into a quart of water, which I'm going to leave to activate for a day, and then I will be spraying the top of the soil of all my pepper plants with this. So anyway, that's just a little correction, and we're still waiting to see how this goes. I actually have a more definitive test set up. I'm testing two different things here. I have three Petri dishes. One that has a tablespoon of gelatin that was mixed with a teaspoon of sugar not in this amount, but in the cup and a half I made. I have agar, which was, I think, a cup and a half-ish, also has a teaspoon of sugar mixed in. And then I have the clear crystals that they sell for kitty litter, because there's a bunch of people on the internet saying that that's the best way to start seeds. So I've got three different methods. I have a dozen bok choy seeds in each one of these. When they start to grow, I'm going to remove the lids and see if they attract the fungus gnats, because it will be very easy to see the fungus gnat larvae in this system. And then we'll try the BTI spray on them. Anyway, that's it for now, and thanks for watching.